that's how much play is in there. We are going to be breaking down the M3D Crane Dual Extruder. It's basically half of their quad extruder. We're going to break it down today and have a look inside and see what's going on with it. So let's go ahead and get started. So first off, I'm going to go ahead and remove these screws, but I got to use the right MT Torx here. Eight. There's 10 right there. Alright, so we will remove one screw. Two screws. And this last one is a little touchy because the faceplate just falls right off. So there we go. There is the faceplate for that. Zoom in down there on that, take a quick look at them. Soften up the brightness a little bit. There we go. So as you can see, that is the plate. Machined all out of aluminum. Has bearing spots for tiny little bearings. Let's see here. Is a BIC pin. So to give you an idea of how big that is, there's the cap to the BIC pin. They are tiny bearings. And then if we look up here at the actual hot end, you can see the channels where the filament goes in. Here is the right side. As it comes in, goes down, and then here is the left side. Basically, this hole here and this hole here is for the bearings for the shafts to go on the other side of the quad. Now, on here, the little bearings do come off the end of these. And I'm going to pull this gear out for you. And of course, the other bearing drops out. Again, it is tiny. We'll just go down here and we'll take a look at these real quick. So it has a bearing on the side. It has, if I can keep it in focus here, a big bearing on the side. Okay, and inside they have two little spring clips to help grab onto the motor. That bearing comes off and it's machined all out of one part. This one has filament in it still. There is no no tension adjustment on these. They are pretty much, let's cut this filament off this hot end here. Back out a little bit. No tension adjustment on that. It pretty much adjusts. It's already set to a set amount. Looks like my filament broke off inside there, so I need to heat this up, pull that out. But that's the hot end, and we will go ahead and do that, and get things going. Here are the two fan wires, and then the motor is going to the small steppers. Trying to take a look here, see what I need to do to get these off. I mean, look at the play in that. I don't know if you, let me adjust the camera again up here. Look at the play in the hot end. That, if you notice, the back plate, let's just go around here to the side. Zoom in a little further here. Pull these wires up. So you can see the plate here in the back. But then if you look at the motor, that's how much play is in there. That's not good. So we are going to go grab a wrench real quick. All right, welcome back, folks. I did find the little wrench that they provide you to adjust tension. So let's go in here and loosen this nut. Let's see if I can. Do as they recommend. And I don't see that happening. So there's the belt. It's undone. Side one, side two, there we go. Maybe. There we go. These. And of course those are different because you can't use the same stuff. So we take these here, and it looks like they've got standoffs, so I'm going to have a wrench. Hopefully this wrench will connect. No. And that won't go in there. So let's see. There we go. can't hold on to nothing. Fingers don't work anymore like they used to. Once I contracted Castleman's disease, I haven't been able to. Fingers just don't work the same. Joint pain. Almost like I have RA. Alright, so there's that. So there you go. There are the two motors. Looks like they're using two sticker materials. Let's see how we get this apart. Two, the fan's off there. All right. So there you have it. Two blowers on the side. I had a print that failed and the print stuck to the hot end. Fan on the back to blow through to keep it cool. See, it looks like we have some really tiny I've been told by people that they've had motors in their quad and others fail. So what is that? That is a Torx 6 actually, although they look like Allen. We'll see. I think they're Allen, but this works. Whoa! Alright, I gotta go find. Looks like they got some spring washers in there. So there are spring washers between the motor and the block on each screw. So, and it looks like these motors just slide in. So they're held in via clips. And the other one slides right out. There you go. And they're just using standard Chinese 5 volt fans. This one on the back is held in with some screws. Oh, nope. Both sides. It's bigger than that. And again, probably a size I don't have. and that's just wrapped around the end there. And then that's not cool. All right, there is the fan shroud, which is a very good quality design. I really like that design. So that I don't lose these, let's slide those out. So there you have it. That is what it is out of the hot end. So let's go ahead and see if we can get this heated up and get the heater block cleaned up and taken apart. We'll go ahead and turn it on. Set the temperature to 190 because we're dealing with PLA. And off to the races. Here. Hit all the parts. So for a quick count, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27 pieces to the hot end, not including the carrier and the screw for the carrier. All right, where are we at? We are at 190. See there on the display, we're at 180 degrees. Let's go ahead and take this back around. Where I can work on it. And let's see. So, there's that. So it looks like there's our problem right there. Oop. Still have something plugging it up. Looks like some of the black backed up into the nozzle and block that up. Let's see. PTFE. Almost looks like. Goobered up there. And let's see what we can do about down in there. And the PTF part looks like it stops well before the hot end or the heat break, and then there's a metal in there. Let's see here. Is that extruded or does that come back out the other side? No, it extruded a little bit. Alright, so go ahead and turn the heat off. Cool down, turn off the hot end, and go back. There we go, she's cooling down now. Alright, so I want to put this back together. Let's put this up here so you guys can see better. Get a brush to clean those off. Okay, so let's just clean these off with this. First, we're going to take a look at the motors here. And they feel good. Let's do this. Plug them in. Turn the heat back up. Go to the load. And that should allow us to spin the motors. Oh yeah, there we go right there. That motor shot. Look at that. How about this one? Oops. That looks good. There we go. That one works good. Yeah, I can't even hold that one back. Yeah, that one is a torquey little sucker. But this one right here, it's stripped out. So that's not any good. You remember the white one, I believe. Yep. The white ones weren't stripped out. So that's probably the reason why I wasn't getting any extrusion on the left side, because that one was on the left. Alright.